I'm Dr. Roberto Garcia Corral Garcia. I'm an internal medicine resident at Multicentric Program of Medical Specialties at Monterrey Institute of Technology. I will present the case of a 38-year-old male with subacute liver failure treated at our university hospital. He has no relevant family history, no illegal drug and alcohol use. He reports being a heavy smoker and sells fish hooks with concurrent exposure to vinyl chloride. He has no pets, doesn't exercise, has no tattoos or piercings, no history of transfusions or recent vaccines. He had a left inguinal hernioplasty. He has no allergies, no known medical conditions. He complains of caluria, which started 3 months ago, followed by jaundice and fatigue 2 months after the onset. He was assessed at a gastroenterology consult, where physical examination revealed skin and mucosal jaundice, telangiectasia on chest skin, non-tender normal peristaltic abdomen, and visceromegaly were not found. All four extremities presented jaundice. Initial vital signs were normal. Initial workup included complete blood count, metabolic panel, liver function tests, and coagulation profile. The tests showed altered PTT, high LDH, high AP, conjugated hyperbilirubinemia, hypertransaminosemia as much as 20-fold the upper normal limit, and the patient was admitted for further workup. Serology for HIV, HSV1, HSV2, HVV, HCV, HAV, CMV, and syphilis were negative. Furthermore, SMA, LKM1, and ANAs were reported negative as well. Portal Doppler and biliary ultrasound revealed diffuse thickening of the gallbladder wall, free intraperitoneal fluid, and subtly high resistive index of the hepatic artery at 0.78. Liver biopsy was performed, and pathology report concluded submassive hepatic necrosis and bridging necrosis on 30 to 40% of lobules and fibrosis. Since the most common causes of ALI were ruled out, the only remaining likely cause of ALI was environmental exposure to vinyl chloride.